Uta Halee Girls Village, an agency helping children with emotional and mental issues, says it can help no more. It's closing, blaming a sea of red tape and state policy, which it says falls far short of helping children in crisis.
Our governor has the power to change this. It's that simple.
Uta Halee leaders call the closure a heartbreaking decision. Good evening, I'm Brandi Peterson.
I'm Rob McCartney. Advocates for children say Nebraska policy is to blame, and children will be victimized again. KATV Newswatch Evans' Melissa Holman begins our Big Story team coverage. Melissa.
Rob, Uta Halee is the only all-girls residential program in Nebraska. Last year, it helped more than 124 girls and more than 700 additional boys and girls receive service through other Uta Halee programs. But beginning next month, none of those services will be available.
My daughter, and I say this with no exaggeration, would perhaps not have graduated from high school, perhaps not have even made it to her 26th birthday.
Leslie Byer says her family is one of Uta Halee's success stories. A happy ending, she says, might not have happened without the help received here at the Omaha Residential Girls Home. But the end is near. Uta Halee will close next month.
This was not an easy decision. This is something we had to do.
President Mary Fraser Mines broke the news. Only 14 beds are filled in the facility. Uta Halee blames the low occupancy on a lack of support and revenue from the state of Nebraska. That, Fraser Mines says, makes it impossible to pay qualified staff.
We used to admit one or two kids a week, and we were admitting one a month.
Uta Halee says that's a result of Nebraska's interpretation of new federal Medicaid rules, which limit or deny payments to some children admitted for mental health treatment.
The governor will tell you, well, we don't deny treatment. But they do. They do say no when the therapist or the caseworker requests admission to a place like Uta Halee.
Nebraska Governor Dave Heineman says the new federal law is the heart of the issue, but he declined to address Uta Halee's announcement specifically.
I just got back in the state. I haven't had a chance to review that situation or be brief, so it would be premature for me to comment on that one yet.
90 Uta Halee employees will be let go, and the children who need help here will have to find it elsewhere, if they can find it at all. Uta Halee Board President Jennifer Haman remembers Robert Hawkins, the teen who opened fire at Von Maur 4 years ago. Hawkins was turned away from Uta Halee's Cooper Village when the state would no longer pay for his treatment.
The state says, yeah, no, you're done. You're out of here. I don't want to pay for you anymore. This is what happens in our state. And so we can't have this anymore. How many shootings do we need to have?
Uta Halee managed Cooper Village for the Omaha Home for Boys. It closed back in May, citing similar financial problems plaguing Uta Halee. Too much of state funding shortfall for donors to pick up. Reporting live, Melissa Holman, KETV Newswatch 7.
Melissa, thanks. And the closing of Uta Halee has many wondering what services are left.
And can those remaining help these at-risk teens who desperately need professional help? KETV Newswatch 7's Michelle Bandur is investigating and continues our Big Story team coverage live from the Douglas County Courthouse.
Brandi, those who work here in the juvenile justice system wonder what will happen to the Uta Halee children and believe some of those teens may have to stay in the juvenile detention center even longer. And one judge who has been working in this juvenile justice system says that this has been the most challenging time working with the state in her 17 years on the bench.
The Douglas County Juvenile Court System has come to rely on Uta Halee for providing specific treatment for each young person in trouble.
We're saddened for Uta Halee and the staff, but more particularly for all the kids that this impacts.
Juvenile Judge Elizabeth Sirkovich has presided over the Delinquency Drug Court for more than 10 years and trusts the experienced counselors and therapists.
So with that resource not there, mm-hmm. What does the court do?
Well, scramble, probably.
Scramble to find other qualified facilities. Problem is, Uta Halee is the complete package and meets the needs of kids with behavioral, mental, and substance abuse problems. There's no other place like it in the state. County Attorney Don Klein expects to see more cases come into his office.
Well, the concern is that some people might end up in a detention center longer than they should be, because there's looking for a different place to place them.
This day has been feared by most people in the fields of substance abuse and mental health for days.
Douglas County Commissioner Chris Rogers is a governor-appointed member of the Nebraska Coalition of Juvenile Justice. With the new restrictive Medicaid law, Rogers believes the closing of Uta Halee will cost more in the long run.
How we are serving kids in the whole juvenile justice system, because this is just, you know, the beginning of some of the bricks that are about to come out with budget issues and decisions that people have to make.
We certainly don't want more kids in the juvenile justice system, because that's not the best place to raise children.
I checked with Boys Town and Girls Inc., and both programs say they will be able to accept some of the girls from Uta Halee. Boys Town saying it has similar services. Girls Inc. says it's an after-school program and is an unlocked facility, so won't be able to help all of the girls. And Girls Inc. adding that it's a sad day for the community to lose a program like Uta Halee. Brandy?
Michelle Bandura reporting live from the Douglas County Courthouse tonight. Thanks, Michelle.